know where it is. Maybe you think of a young girl and an older man, and he's dragging her into the bathroom of the store. Maybe you think it's not that big of a deal, since we never hear about it. Maybe you think, why does it affect me? Because it's men and women and small children who are forced to do sexual and labor-related acts by someone who has mocked them. Because it happens all over the world, to hundreds of thousands of people. Because it happens here, in America, in Missouri, in St. Louis, Kansas City, and Springfield. Because it takes away the lives of people just like us. People who wish they could have a childhood, who wish they could get an education, who wish they could have freedom. Because it happened to one of my best friends. Ava was somewhere between the ages of 5 and 7 when her parents sold her as a sex slave into the world of human trafficking. 5 and 7 years old, and she had already gone farther with a man than most of the women our age. She went from Nigeria to Cameroon to Ghana and then the United States. In an interview I conducted with her on April 18th of this year, she said that she remembers one man who hurt her more than the rest. They all beat her, and most would let her eat until they were sexually satisfied, but this man, he made her want to die. With him, she felt worthless, useless, trapped. This isn't just another story on the news. This is a person's life. This is rape. This is prostitution. This is real. Today, I want to talk to you about human trafficking. What human trafficking is, how people are forced into it, how they get out, and what you can do to help. So what is human trafficking? According to the U.S. Department of Justice in 2017, human trafficking involves the use of force, fraud, and coercion to induce an individual to perform commercial sex acts, sex trafficking, or subject them to involuntary servitude, debt bondage, and serfdom, labor trafficking. There are 5 stages in human trafficking: recruitment, transportation, transfer, harboring, and receipt. Recruitment is the acquiring of a victim or victims. Transportation is the movement of those victims from one location to another. Distances that can range from one neighborhood over to across the world. Transfer is the trading or selling of those victims from one owner to the next. Harboring includes the keeping or holding of a person while under one's control. And finally, receipt, also known as receiving whatever exploitation was wanted from that person. Globally, the International Labor Organization estimates that there are 4.5 million people trapped in sexual exploitation. That is approximately 173 times the number of students here at Missouri State. However, human trafficking is a hidden problem. No one truly knows how many victims are out there. Any statistics, or just the tip of the iceberg? As stated by Alexander Levick in her 2016 article, some suffering is recognized, and some goes unnoticed. From physical assaults and beatings, to sexually transmitted diseases, pregnancy, and psychological damage, the effects of human trafficking are too great to ignore. How would people end up in such a twisted cycle of exploitation? According to the UN Office on Drugs and Crime in 2014, victims were transported from 127 countries of origin to 137 destination countries. This means that over 70% of countries in the world participate in human trafficking. Victims can find themselves being exploited in a number of ways. Some might become romantically involved with someone who then forces or manipulates them into prostitution. Others might be lured in with false promises of a job, like modeling or dancing. And still, there are some who are forced to sell sex by their parents or other family members. As stated in their article, their 2018 article, Prince Kelly Constantin and Pham said that the choice to engage in sex work is made against a backdrop of desperation, violence, and coercion. In the United States today, 58% of people being bought, sold, and traded are from here. It's a domestic trade. Who knew that your neighbor, your coworker, your friend could be being exploited? Right now, someone you thought you knew is being forced to do unimaginable things. And all you do talk to them about the weather. It's the tip of the iceberg. So how did they get out? There does exist federal funding specifically for victims of human trafficking, provided by the Department of Health and Human Services. According to the UNODC in 2013, this type of aid can range from anything, including medical and dental services, to shelter and employment. But before we can help them, we have to find them. In an article by the National Research Council in Washington, D.C. in 2013, we find that the best way to find victims of human trafficking is through outreach and public awareness campaigns. Three national level examples of organizations that do this work include Shared Hope International, the Polaris Project, and ECPAT USA. These nonprofit organizations help victims of human trafficking identify themselves, as there can be a lot of fear coming forward. In a 2017 radio broadcast on St. Louis on the Air, we find that many foreign-born victims don't even realize they're being exploited and used against their will. They are simply told that this is what employment looks like in the United States. If the victims themselves don't even realize that they're being trafficked and forced to do things, how are we supposed to help them? How are we supposed to know where to start? How are we supposed to uncover the rest of the iceberg hidden ominously under the water? How can we help? A great way to help is to volunteer and support anti-trafficking efforts in your community. But the best way, according to PolarisProject.org, is to have the victim call 911. Or the 24-hour National Human Trafficking Hotline, run by the Polaris Project. The Polaris Project is a nonprofit national organization that focuses on public awareness and outreach campaigns, as well as running the National Human Trafficking Resource Center and Hotline. Through all of this, the easiest and most impactful way to help and support anti-trafficking advocates is to donate to nonprofit organizations that help victims and survivors of human trafficking. Organizations that have the right equipment and skills to dive into the cold and icy waters looking for the glacier that belongs to the tip of the iceberg. Organizations like the Polaris Project. If you feel compelled to donate, you can go online to polarisproject.org and donate. Or if you have any spare change, I'll be around afterwards collecting money for the Polaris Project and the people they help. The people like my friend Ava. Here at Missouri State, we try not to focus on ourselves, but on the people around us. We stand true to those three pillars: ethical leadership, cultural competence, community engagement. Ethical leadership is taking a stand against human trafficking. Cultural competence is knowing that it is happening, not just in the United States, but all over the world. And community engagement is helping the people in need and getting your community involved in the solution. This is for the people who we don't know are suffering. This is for the men, the women, the girls, and the boys who were forced into a life of helplessness and fear. This is for Ava and the people like her who wish they could have a normal life. This is for humanity.